Good day, everybody. Now we, Victoria Grinevich and Yuliya Zhuravliova, would like to present our scientific research called No Depression, the Most Adapted Pandemic Economy Generation. The outbreak of the Asian coronavirus, unexpected in its scale and significance, became the main news topic in the beginning of this year. A previously unknown infection has suddenly turned into a global problem from which individual states couldn't distance themselves. This event has already caused visible economic shocks on a global scale for financial markets, for businesses, for society. Not all people were ready for such a change, which leads many of them into depression. Therefore, our objectives are to identify the generation most adapted to the pandemic economy and to help the results of our study to those who are most susceptible to the situation. Let's pay attention to the theory of generations. A generation of baby boomers is defined as being from the huge population increase that followed World War II and the Great Depression. As a result, a generation with a psychology of winners appeared. Optimism, interest in personal growth, but at the same time collectivism and team spirit are considered to be their main values. The values of the Generation X, such as willingness to change, the possibility of choice, global awareness, the desire to learn throughout life, the informality of youth, pragmatism, self-reliance, gender equality, were formed until 1993. The event that shaped their values are the continuation of the Cold War, perestroika, AIDS, drugs, the war in Afghanistan. The values of the Generation Y, also called the Millennium Generation, continue to be formed now. Mobile phones, the internet, and modern brands are their usual reality. Their main values are concepts such as civic duty and morality. Generation Z grew up with technology, the internet and social media, which sometimes causes them to be stereotyped as tech addicted. Their values consist of human equality, family, personal success, financial security and transparency. Next, we would like to draw attention to the data of a social survey conducted online among 1,000 people over 18 years of age. The results were addressed by a joint project of the online market intelligence platform and the social effect research platform COVID-19. The first question was a fear for the health and a fear for the family budget. It should be noted that among the respondents, fear of economic consequences rather than the disease itself is more pronounced. This is the fear of the unknown. Generation Z faced with a crisis for the first time at conscious age, and for the generation of millennials and Generation X, the crisis is different from the previous ones.
The next question presented changes in the working environment of the respondents from the moment the disease spread. The result of the survey can observe. The main difference between the Generation Z is still less than career ambitions than among older fellow citizens. Generation Z has not only physiological, but also psychological immunity to coronavirus. At the same time, the later representatives of the Millennial Generation and Generation X will probably have difficulty finding remote work. Thus, a huge number of unemployed people begin to form in the economy, temporarily without the ability to find at least some work. How and what can you do to improve the situation? We conclude the study with this question. As you can see, the survey result presented. We can see the trend that Generation Z and Millennials have more easily adapted to today's economic conditions. On the one hand, we can observe that the budgetary assessment of various areas in favor of the new generation is already beginning. The most entrepreneurial people are well aware that the value of Generation Z and the Millennials are turning into a trend in the global economy. On the other hand, we can observe the older generation, which is simply forced to adapt to the current circumstances. Whether they can do this or not, but without specific actions aimed at living in isolation and reducing the risk of infection, they simply will not survive. And to the conclusion to our story, we would like to draw attention to possible changes in the economy. Now there is a global crisis, which we already noticed by increasing the unemployed. For the state, this will become a heavy burden to pay pensions at the current level and unemployment benefits for an increasing number of people. And since the demographic trend has already led us to the fact that the number of pensioners exceeds the number of working population, the situation becomes unbearable. Currently, online consumption is becoming the most common. In order to preserve companies and the business as a whole, entrepreneurs draw attention to the possible online services. Now there is a unique opportunity to develop in this direction for those who didn't have any internet platform, application, or patron social networks before. Firstly, you can select a job for remote work. This is a great chance to get at least some kind of income. Secondly, now there is an opportunity to adapt the older generation to the online consumption. For example, a grocery can offer the service of delivering a specific basket of products by time. Thus, it turns out that the older generation remains as isolated as possible and the company receives a new client. In addition, it's possible to allocate a workplace for such an employee who will be engaged in the data collection and offer company service. We hope that these measures can be used by companies and help us to survive in the future crisis conditions. Thank you for your attention.